Hello Africa, hello Uganda, hello South Sudan. I'm Bangzi, your host today at Urban TV, representing Miss Equatoria fashion beauty pageant that happened last night. It was really a night of fashion and music. To cut it short, we had ladies coming from Kuku, from Bari, we had Pojulu, we had Lotuko. All these came together from South Sudan competing during this impressing the peace that has just recently been signed in South Sudan. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, today we are just here to show you the talent we have in South Sudan with these young ladies here. We had the queen, we had the first runner, the second runner, and we shall be hearing something from them as they get to tell us more about what they were doing that night, how they felt, what experience they have, and what they will be doing out for us.
Harriet, contestant number 5.
I'm called Yango Joyce. Contestant number 9.
Called Leila B. Raimondo. My number is number 11, as you can see.
My name is Catherine Lino Hassan. I'm contestant number 4.
My name is Kia Ismail. Contestant number 2.
I'm called Joanne Veronica Wani. And I'm contestant number 12.
Sylvia Ambrose Lomi Futia. I'm contestant number 10. Pojulu by Tribe.
Lotuko culture wear that is from Mr. Equatoria.
The love for my culture, the love for fashion inspired me.
I'm contesting to become the first ever Miss Equatoria. Reason why, because like I love my people and I'm trying to inspire other youth.
The reason as to why I contest is that since the war broke in our land, South Sudan, many children have lost their parents. And I've seen that it's not good. I'm not happy to see children suffering. I love children. So I applied in order to help them.
This one, we call it a blusa. This is like a shirt to cover the body. And this one, it's normally worn by the youth, not the married people.
I'm a Pojulu by tribe. And what I'm wearing is my culture, Pojulu culture. And the beads, they represent respect to the royal families, to the elders, and to the community leaders. Then the skirt, this one we call it tondura in our local language, and it is basically made like this to impress the audience. If you dance, it gives that impression in the faces of the audience.
As in dancing, I love doing it like my passion. I really love dancing. Whenever I watch people dance, I feel like I'm inspired. So whenever I hear the word music, I feel like I should also do it. Jack it up.
I come from a family of a lot of girls. And where I come from, most girls do not go to school. So today I'm here to sensitize the girls, inspire them, tell them about the advantages of being in school.
Of course, I have so many plans. My first plan is will be like, I wanted to make an orphan, but I can't do that right now, so I will be very grateful to help those one who already exist.
You can see I have a cassava leaf, that is a gadia in my language, and this is a bogodi in my language, as you can see.
This is my traditional wear. It's called Madi. It's a Madi tribe. So that's how they wear and they dance with it.
I'm coming to present my culture as I'm contesting for Miss Equatoria in Uganda.
Where I came from, there's high rate of school dropout, and the first thing that I want to do is to eradicate education. So by getting the crown, it's very easy for me to reach out to the communities and talk to the young girls and boys the importance of education.
We are Nilohamites, we are farmers, so we love to grow crops like fruits and vegetables.
Inspire myself that let me contest for this Miss Equatoria, so that by me contesting, those girls who are out there, they will look at me, they will feel jealous, they will get jealous. And of course, after them getting jealous, they will come and not contest.
And I know what I'm doing to make me to win.
So far I'm trying and I know I'll make it.
I'm expecting to win tonight.
If I don't win, of course nobody will win. It's me and I'm confident I have to win.
The dream, it has come long ago, because when I was young, it was in 2009. By that time, if I'm to remember, I have 12 years old. And I was like, when it reaches 2020, I wanted to become the Miss South Sudan.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we have the queen today here from Bari, and we have the second runner from Podjulu. We also have the Miss Creativity from Madi. They will be telling us how the experience they had during that night, and then that is all about Miss Equatoria South Sudan. This is a beauty contest coming from South Sudan for the first time, hitting us up on Urban TV here. And we're really so grateful, and we appreciate so much the work that Urban TV and the love that they're showing us here from Uganda.
When you really want something, you have to strike very hard to get it. You have to be determined, you have to be focused, and both courageous.
My name is Catherine Lina Hassan. I'm 22 years old, a student at Kampala University.
I'm just one person who loves to be happy.
It's all about Miss Equatoria Beauty Pageant.
Equatoria, yeah. It's back in South Sudan, my homeland.
The reason why I came up with this Miss Equatoria is that I am a model, and what can I do to my fellow sisters and maybe brothers? That's why I came up with this concept of Miss Equatoria. Why? I want to educate them. I also want to share what I got from my modeling industries and then the experience that I have.
Yeah, I really had some challenges, but actually I felt so good when I was announced as the queen.
It wasn't really easy because I joined late, but it was all about hard work that led to my success. I really worked hard and tried to make it too.
How I think about creativity, it's just something simple that can make you look unique and beautiful, like among so many other people. So you have to come out with it, and you have to show it to other people who need it to see that.
It's actually my first time, and I got a challenge of like preparing my creative wear, because I really needed to think about it before I do it. I wanted to collect ideas from different places to come about with that. Jack it up.
I really hope so. In fact, what these girls did last time, it was really amazing, and everyone is so proud about that. And all the South Sudanese are really happy for what these ladies, the queens, did on that day. And then we are looking forward in taking them, catch their dreams, and reaching to the highest as our dream.
First of all, we want to thank God for having peace in my country. And what I can tell them is we should continue to live in peace, harmony, and we should love one another.
I can promise to keep that smile from now on, to be like with it for good. And it at that training place, it was like just something like when you be worried whether you can do it right or wrong, but when you do it right, it just makes you happy and proud. The only advice I'm giving ladies is that you should come out and show us your creativity, your beauty, your talent, and everything you have.
I would like to tell other people who couldn't, like, there are so many places where you can make something great out of nothing. So you should focus and look for the right place to do something great for yourself.
The advice I have for my dear Equatorians is that we should be united. We should come together and help each other.
There are very many people who are seated on their talents, but it's all about trying. We shouldn't fail to try. The moment you try, that's when you know that your dreams can come true.
Uganda is really a very good, beautiful country, peaceful and all that. The fact that most people from different countries come to study from Uganda. And then I would like to tell the Ugandans, the young ones, they should not only focus on what Uganda got for them, but they should also get some different ideas and different things from the different countries.
Yeah, I would like to tell Urban TV and the people who are following Urban TV, it's like, it's actually, there is no other TV which would like to work with South Sudan, so it's really nice of them.
It has been one of my best TV stations in Uganda ever since I came to Uganda, and I really appreciate Urban TV a lot because of what they do.
And thank them so much. And for the followers, like, it's really great to follow Urban TV because they bring something new from different places.
Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, it is just not a goodbye, but it says see you later. I remain your host today, Bangzi, Urban TV.